So, 12th class, yesterday I was discussing with you update command. Okay, so continuing that topic, connect database commerce, select star from employee, right? A science section. We have created one database with the name commerce, and under that database, I have created one table with the name employee. So all the science section students, please, table is in front of you. I am giving you few seconds so that you can go through the fields and the records of the table. And when I'll be continuing with the commands, you are in touch of the table. Okay, Vidisha, are you here in the lecture? Vidisha, please take attendance of the commerce class and send to me on WhatsApp. Yesterday, we completed the update command. Update command, as you know, is used to update the existing records of the table. It is used to update the existing records of the table. Clear? Now, let us continue. Alter table. Today, I'll be discussing alter table command. Alter table command, as by name, it is very much clear. It is used to make amendments or changes in the existing table. It is used to make changes or modifications in the existing table. Since it deals with the table itself, this command comes under the category of DDL command. Okay, an update command comes under the category of DML commands. Clear? Now, suppose you want to add a new column. Right now, I have five columns: E code, E name, E salary, E department, E city. Okay, suppose you want to add one new column. Then how you can add the column by using alter command and add keyword, right? Like I'm saying, alter table employee, add keyword, data field name, Aadhaar, and type of the field, string type. Okay. Alter table name employee, add keyword. Add keyword means you are adding a new column to your existing table. And the name of the field, I have taken Aadhaar, means Aadhaar card. And the data type of the field, I have taken the data type string, character of size 20. Now, when you will display the records of the table, carefully see the last field Aadhaar. All the values are null. All the values are null. Why null? Because after entering the five records, then you added a new column Aadhaar. So for the previous records, the new column will have null value. For the previous records, the newly added column will have the null value. Am I clear to all of you up till here? Yes, Dhruv Sharma, am I clear? Sukhmani, Jasdev, Ishpuneet, Gaurav, Lagan. Lagan, am I clear? Daman, Vidisha, Bhavneet, Anshita, Avish, Sushant, Nandini, Charanjot, am I clear? Shitij, Ruchika, Vaibhav. Up till here, concept is clear to all of you? Vaibhav. All right. Now, how to update the new field? How to update the new field? I am creating one command here. See carefully. Update employee. अब जो नया फील्ड मैंने इंसर्ट किया है उसके अंदर नल वैल्यू है. अब हर एम्प्लॉई के लिए वैल्यू कैसे देनी है? अपडेट एम्प्लॉई सेट आधार इक्वल टू AA111 बिकॉज योर आधार नंबर इज ऑफ स्ट्रिंग टाइप सो इट कैन बी अल्फा न्यूमेरिक. Okay, right, where e code equal to 1001. For updating the Aadhaar card for every employee, use the update command by putting the condition, like I have taken the condition, jis employee ka e code 1001 hai, उसका आधार कार्ड सेट कर दो 8811 से. अपडेट टेबल का नाम, सेट कीवर्ड, जिस फील्ड को सेट करना है दैट फील्ड नेम इक्वल टू द वैल्यू दैट यू वांट टू गिव, वेयर कंडीशन, किस बेसिस पे चेक करना है एम्प्लॉय को, सर्चिंग कैसे करनी है एम्प्लॉय की. आई एम सर्चिंग द एम्प्लॉय ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ ई कोड, राइट. One record updated. If you want to check the table, you can check it. See the first record. Aadhaar card has been updated for the Ashish employee. Is it clear up till here? Similarly, you can set values for other records. Like update Aadhaar card. A112 where e code equal to 1002. Okay. Updated. Then again, set Aadhaar card equal to AA113 where e code equal to 1003. Then fourth record, update Aadhaar card BB111. Where e code equal to 1004. And last record, update Aadhaar card BB112, where e code equal to 1005. So all the Aadhaar card values have been updated. Then you can give command select star from employee. Check it out. Is it okay? Now comes the concept of in command. In operator is used when you want to check for the values in the given list of values. Like you have between command. Between command is used to specify the records that satisfies the given range. Similarly, when you give the in operator, you specify the list and your record should be printed. Only those records should get printed which satisfies the given range. Okay, which satisfies the value given in the list. Select star from employee where e department in, any department में से department होना चाहिए, जिनका department given department में से है उनका record print हो जाए, sales, then is finance. All the employees which are having department sales or finance, only their record should get print. Check it out. Check the records. Ashish, Chetan and Dheeraj, these are the three employees who belongs to sales, finance and sales department again. Rest of the records are not displayed. Because only these three employees satisfies the given condition. Okay? Now, not in. Not in is the reverse of in. Not in is the reverse of in. In says, those employees which belong to sales and finance, their record should get print. Not in says, all the employees who do not belong to sales and finance department, their record should get print. So record of Aditya and Dhruv, they get print. All the students who are having clear concept up till here, raise your thumb immediately so that I can proceed with the next important concept, constraints. And Vidisha, please make sure about attendance. Whose thumb is up and who is not. Manviya, concept is clear? Okay, Sanvinder? Daman, Anushka, concept is clear to both of you? No response is coming from your side. Vidisha, Mohit, Bhavneet, no response coming. All right. Now I'm starting with the concept of constraints. What is the general meaning of constraints? Check, condition, restriction, validation. To make yourself easy, you can use any word. What in general sense constraint means? Constraint means a condition that we apply to the columns of the table in order to restrict the type of values that can be added into the column. Hamare column mein kaun si values aa sakti hain, kaun si values nahi aa sakti, हम इसके ऊपर एक चेक रख देते हैं, हम इसके ऊपर एक कंडीशन लगा देते हैं. That condition when applied, it will put restriction on us that what type of values can be entered in the column and what type of values cannot be entered in the column. That is called constraints. So far we are working with MySQL. What all constraints we have to do? Not null constraint, primary key constraint, unique key constraint, default constraint, foreign key constraint, check constraint. These are the different type of constraints that can be applied in the database. Okay. Now I am creating one small table from the very beginning to make you understand the clear meaning of every constraint. Okay? Create table. Table one. I'll be making small tables to explain each and every constraint, so that you people get familiar with this concept. So my first table is tab 1. Serial number, integer, name, character, ten size, not null. I have applied the constraint not null. Not null constraint signifies that my column cannot contain null value. To whichever column you have applied not null constraint, now you cannot enter null value in that column. The database will highlight the error if you will try to enter null value in that column where not null constraint is applied. Am I clear? Score of type float. Now here I am going to put another constraint that is called default constraint. Default constraint means user does not specify any value for the field, for the column, but database itself provide any value. अगर यूजर वैल्यू नहीं दे रहा तो बाय डिफॉल्ट डाटाबेस अपनी तरफ से कोई वैल्यू बाय डिफॉल्ट इंसर्ट कर देगा. सो हाउ टू सेट द डिफॉल्ट कंस्ट्रेंट, जिस भी फील्ड पे डिफॉल्ट कंस्ट्रेंट लगाना है, डाटा टाइप के बाद डिफॉल्ट कीवर्ड, स्पेसिफाई द वैल्यू. आई एम गिविंग द वैल्यू 50. 50 वैल्यू विल बी एंटर्ड बाय डिफॉल्ट इफ द यूजर ट्राइज टू स्किप the value of the score. User does not provide any value for the score field. You can provide. If you will provide, it will override the default value. Okay. Now I'm entering the first record. Insert into tab 1. Values. Serial number 1. Name AA. Score 60. One record entered. Second record. Insert into tab 1. I am giving after table name, specify the fields for which you want to give the value. Serial number. Okay. Clear? And name. Serial number 2, name I am giving null. I am not giving any value for score. I have given null value in the name field. The database has given the error. Column name cannot be null. Anybody can tell me why the error has come? That will clearly prove the child is very much available and totally serious in the lecture. Manviya has raised hand. Yes, Manviya, unmute yourself, bache.
We have drum's name.
Your voice is not audible to me clearly, Manviya. Can you please set your speakers? Again, unmute yourself. Manviya, am I audible?
Sir, because yes. We have applied not null constraint,
yes, very right.
To the second column.
Very right, very correct. Excellent response. Because we have already applied the constraint not null to the name field. So we cannot enter the null value. Now, how to rectify it? We have to provide any name. I am giving the name BB. Okay. Now see, after providing the value to the name field, I am not giving any value for the score field. मैंने स्कोर फील्ड के लिए कोई वैल्यू नहीं दी, फिर भी मेरा रिकॉर्ड एंटर हो गया. आई एम नॉट गिविंग एनी वैल्यू फॉर द स्कोर फील्ड, स्टिल माय डाटाबेस इज एक्सेप्टिंग माय रिकॉर्ड बिकॉज डाटाबेस विल एलोकेट द डिफॉल्ट वैल्यू इन द कॉलम ऑफ स्कोर बिकॉज I have already set the constraint default in the score field. Check the table carefully. पहले record में तो 60 value आपने enter की थी ना, दूसरे में आपने score value छोड़ दी थी, तो database ने वहां पर default value enter कर दी. जिन्हें यहां तक clear है thumb raise करो, फिर मैं आगे proceed करूं. Jasdev Singh, no response coming from you today. What is the matter? Mujhe naam kyun announce karna padta hai lecture mein? Vance teacher said, give the response means you are to give the response. Okay. Now I'm in mood to ask few questions and I'm finding from whom should I ask. Okay, Vaibhav, unmute yourself. Vaibhav, am I audible? Vaibhav, your voice is not audible to me. Set up your speakers. Shitij, unmute yourself.
Yes, sir.
Shitij, name any four constraints that we can apply on the table. Unmute. Shitij, unmute yourself. I think he's not in the lecture. Anyhow, now moving to the next constraint. Okay. Okay, one record more I want to enter. Insert into tab 1 values 3, CC, 80. Okay, so total I have 3 records, right? Select star from tab 1. Now I create another table, tab 2. Roll number, integer. Here I am going to apply the very important constraint, primary key. What is primary key? Primary key is a key, is a constraint that uniquely identify each record in the table. It differentiates one record from the other. I give one example from your school life. We have two sections, 12th A and 12th B. Listen the example carefully and then correlate this example with your primary key constraint concept. 12th A and 12th B are two sections. If there is roll number 1 in 12th A, there will be roll number 1 in 12th B also. Agar main ek section ki baat karun, ek particular section ki baat karun, तो रोल नंबर वन एक ही बच्चे का होगा, 12th A में रोल नंबर वन एक ही बच्चे का होगा, नो टू स्टूडेंट्स कैन हैव द सेम रोल नंबर, बट इन अदर सेक्शन अगेन देयर विल बी रोल नंबर वन. नाउ कम टू द एंटायर स्कूल, थिंक अबाउट ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स इन द एंटायर स्कूल. All the students are having unique admission numbers. No two students in the school will have the same admission number. Agar 2500 students hain, to 2500 different admission numbers honge. No two students in the entire school can have the same admission number. So what is admission number? Primary key. We can differentiate among the students on the basis of admission number. Okay? Similarly, in one table, there can be only and only one primary key. In one table, you cannot have more than one primary key. Clear? Second feature of primary key. To whichever field you apply the primary key, remember two important conditions. You cannot enter null value in the field of primary key. You cannot repeat the value. You cannot enter duplicate value in that column which you have specified as primary key. तो तीन बातें याद रखना, एक टेबल में सिर्फ एक प्राइमरी की हो सकती है. सेकेंड, यू कैन नॉट हैव डुप्लीकेट वैल्यूज इन द प्राइमरी की फील्ड. थर्ड, यू कैन नॉट एंटर नल वैल्यू. ओके, मार्क्स, फ्लोट. वन मेथड इज हाउ टू स्पेसिफाई प्राइमरी की. फील्ड नेम, डाटा टाइप, आफ्टर द डाटा टाइप राइट प्राइमरी की. ओके, सेकेंड वे, अगर आपने डाटा टाइप के बाद प्राइमरी की नहीं लिखा तो कोई बात नहीं. आप क्या करोगे, आप जहां पे आपका टेबल खत्म होना है ना, उसके बाद एंटर दबा के, जैसे एंटर दबाया, प्राइमरी की ब्रैकेट, राइट द रोल नंबर, राइट द फील्ड टू विच यू वांट टू ऐड प्राइमरी की एंड क्लोज द टेबल. If you have not mentioned the primary key after the column name, second method to specify the primary key is write primary key after all the fields, in bracket write the field name and close the table bracket. Okay? Now here I am giving the grade, single character. Okay? Now I add the record. Insert into tab 2, values, roll number 1, marks 50, grade A. Single character hai, grade A. Okay. I add one more record. Here I repeat the value. रोल नंबर पर प्राइमरी की है, पर मैं बच्चे का रोल नंबर रिपीट कर रहा हूं. प्राइमरी की हैज गिवन द एरर. सी, डाटाबेस हैज गिवन द एरर, डुप्लीकेट एंट्री वन फॉर की वन. दिस एरर कम्स बिकॉज वी हैव डिक्लेयर्ड रोल नंबर फील्ड एज प्राइमरी की. सो वी हैव टू करेक्ट इट. You cannot enter duplicate values. You have to correct it. Okay. Now, second condition of primary key. You cannot enter null value. RNO marks grade values null marks 40 grade C. Okay. Again, error comes. Column roll number cannot be null. Why? The field which has been declared as primary key, you cannot add null value to that. Primary key field mein null value kabhi nahi aa sakti. Am I clear? So we have to rectify it. Clear? So this is our table. Am I totally clear with default constraint, not null and primary?